Oh, hello. Welcome to the first episode of Cocktails and Candies. I am September. I am your artist for the evening. Maybe some light entertainment here and there. We will be creating a therapeutic space in our homes somewhere, wherever you can dip off, even if it's the bathroom. Go into the restroom, take a little table, lock the door, get your easel ready, get your paints ready, and we are going to do a little bit of art therapy mixed with some libations and maybe a few jokes that we aren't supposed to tell, but we're going to tell them today. So I'm going to get started. I'm going to light my little candle and create my space. Got a little ambiance music in the background. Let me change the station. It's always important to create a space that is going to be conducive with right brain activity. You don't want anything too hectic. You want it to be nice and clean, so here we are. Now, number one, I have a few rules when I do this class. Now, I do these classes live. I am out of Cleveland, Ohio. However, I will be doing these classes online. So the first rule is this. If you are a beginner painter, allow yourself to build the artwork. It will come in layers. Initially, when it starts off, it's going to be highly questionable. You're going to look at it like, what is that? And then once you begin to build it and cultivate it, it'll start to refine itself and you'll be able to step back and see a picture. So give it time. Number two, if you are a perfectionist, no real good art is made off of perfection. There's always something that isn't necessarily right. Especially if you talk to any artist, there's always something that they can continue to work on in the picture just to make it more detailed or give it more color or more vibrant. So nothing is perfect, that's my point. Last but not least, and this will be the most important rule, watch where you dip in your paintbrush, the drinks, the paint water. It can mesh itself together. Do not drink the paint water and do not dip your paintbrush into your alcohol, because this is what's gonna happen. You're gonna be faced with a life decision. Do you wanna drink? Or are you gonna waste that alcohol? So please be cognizant, people, of where you're dipping your brush, okay? Art is life, art is life. So I'm gonna set the mood. I'm gonna cut on some Erykah Badu. That's what I like to listen to. Cut on whatever you like to listen to. And we are going to paint today. I've picked this really awesome picture. We are going to paint a sailboat. Now, I'm out of Cleveland, Ohio. It's snowing here. So I picked a picture that I could kind of imagine myself being there, because I'm not indigenous to this climate. We're gonna leave it at that. So here we go, let me get to it. All right, so I found this picture and I thought it was very straightforward, easy to do, and it would look nice in any home. I'm not sure if it's gonna show you the colors it needs to be shown. However, you'll see it as I paint it. So it's a sailboat on some water. Very straightforward picture. So it's important to always have your photo reference. I have to step off camera to grab my paint. Now, if you are going to join in to have a monthly membership, what you will be getting in your box will be a set of four canvases for each piece of artwork we do weekly. Some of them will be pre-traced for you already on the canvas by myself, by me. Some of them will be blank because we will begin to paint off of blank canvas. Also in your box, it will include round tip brushes, flat tip brushes, the colors you may need for that particular week and that particular painting. You'll also receive a scented candle. These are always important to set the ambiance. You will receive some disposable aprons, and sometimes I may throw a surprise in there, sometimes I may not. We don't know. We're gonna stay on our toes. All right. What I want to do here is look at my photo and say what my base colors are going to be. So I'm gonna pull out. I'm gonna pull out an orange. Give me a little purple iris, a little orange here. I have very basic paints. I like to start with very basic paints for beginners. Now for my more personal artwork, I do use different quality paints. But this is good when you're starting out. You're able to learn to manipulate your medium. Your medium being your paint. It's always important to have white and black. White and black are very important. Very important colors. So I've got my white. I'm gonna grab my orange. Some yellow. This is a very colorful portrait. And get a little bit of yellow. And if I need any other colors, I'll grab them as I go. Let's see, let's get this in here. It's a little better. I don't wear any makeup, so I hope my face not looking too crazy. But here we go. All right, so what I'm gonna start with is my background. And I'm gonna take the fattest brush that I have. I also have some paper towels available. You wanna make sure you keep these available for you. See, I got my cup of water here. Got my varied size brushes in here. Today I'm gonna be using an oval tip brush. Start from my background. So, I'm gonna dip into this Brazilian, this Bahama Breeze-esque type blue. And I'm gonna start with my canvas sky, my background. Now it's important to think about the strokes on your canvas because that's going to create the motion in your picture. Now this is something I also make everyone aware of when we do any type of artwork. Art imitates life. Edges are important. Edges are important in life. Edges are important in art. Okay, we want to always paint our edges so you have a complete portrait. We want to always maintain our edges so you have a complete hairstyle. Okay, just figured I'd throw that in there for you. So we're going to create kind of a circular motion for our sky. So I'm going to come around, and if you notice, there's really not too much tactic in here. I just want to slap it on the canvas, get the paint on the canvas, and feel no fear. You got to go into this fearlessly. You try to be too strategic, you're going to overthink it, you're going to overwork it, and that's not good art. You don't want to overwork it. You don't want to overwork it. So if you notice, I'm leaving maybe a quarter of my canvas down here. I'm going to go ahead and line that off because this is going to be my horizon or my water. Leave about a quarter of my canvas empty. Now as I go, I'm going to begin to blend in a little bit of white to create some variation in the color for my background. Also too, our sailboat's going to rest on the lightest part of our sky, so that's where we're going to create the space for our sailboat. You following along with me? Sweet. Make sure I get my edges. You know, gotta have that edge control. Edge control. No flyaways. So I'm gradually blending in a little bit of white with my background, and I'm keeping the same motions. And my paintbrush is creating this nice, nice focal point in the center of my canvas. And again, I'm going to reiterate, that's where the sailboat is going to go. It's right in the center of the canvas. Nice focal point. And it's going to bleed out rather nicely. You want to bring it out to the edge. Bring the color back in. So we create awesome space. Go back into my white. Now, it doesn't have to be this color. This is your artwork. You make it be what you want. And gradually what you'll see happen is as we create our background and spaces, my right brain will take hold and I will start to add color everywhere because, hey, it's Colorful Mess Studios. It's the name of my business. Color is my game. I love it. So I'm gonna add in a little bit more blue here. And just kind of start with a horseshoe motion to complete my center. Go back into my white. Okay, we got a little reggae going on in the background. Now, we all have long work weeks. Children, people demanding our attention. And this time during our week is for us, is mine. I'm not cooking anybody anything. If you can't find anything for yourself, order something to eat. I'm not running any errands for anybody during this time. If you need an errand ran, you better Uber. Call someone, put out a bat signal. But this is my paint time. Don't come knocking on my door unless you want to say hello. And ask me if I need anything. That's what you can do. Ask me if I need anything. I know y'all know what I'm talking about. Tell them, come, hey, do you need anything? You don't need, okay, leave me alone. Okay, so we're gonna finish this off at the bottom. And you can see how, once I start, I'm gonna fall apart. Once I start to separate my bottom with a different stroke line, how it sets a different tone for this area of my painting. So what I'm going to begin to do down here is create this beautiful water that I see happening. So I'm gonna start off with some orange. I'm gonna sweep in here in the same direction, straight across my canvas. I'm gonna go in with a little bit more orange. Go in with a little bit of orange here. And then I think I'm gonna clean my brush off. Alright. Now I've got a darker blue hue on my plate, so I'm gonna come in with that. Try not to knock my water over, so that's no good. And once this background is completed, we will take a break, grab a drink. I'm gonna go back in and clean my brush off again. Come in with some purple. Purple is always lovely. Just gives it so much richness. It's my favorite color. Maybe I'm a little biased. Excuse me. I'm creating my water. And this is where my boat will rest. And clean my brush off again. Bring a little bit of yellow in here. Now, yellow is one of those colors. It's pretty, it's like you don't expect it. I don't know why that couldn't come out. You don't expect it to do what it does, but it does what it do. It made sense to me. I hope it made sense to you. Ooh, bars, bars. Okay, okay. So I'm gonna come in with a little bit of yellow. And this always seems to just add such vibrance and wake up the canvas in ways that a lot of colors aren't able to. Like if you find yourself with too many dark colors and it's too melancholy, add a little bit of yellow. Too much heat, the yellow break the monotony all up in there. So I'm gonna let this be my first layer. Let it dry for a second. Add a defined horizon line at the top with my purple. Go ahead and define this horizon line with the purple. Okay. And here is where our boat, our sailboat will be. Now, what I'm gonna do is clean my brush off. Always make sure you have water. Clean your brush off. And the last thing before we take our break is I'm gonna dip into my white. And I'm gonna create what is gonna be seen to be kind of a reflection. Now I may have to let this dry a little more, which I probably will, and I'll come back over it. But this white here, creating the space for it now, excuse me, will become like a reflection. Go back in with a little bit more yellow. Told you artists are never done. And I'm tempted to put a little bit of red in here. Let's see what that'll look like. That may be nice. A little bit of red or magenta. I'm not sure which one I'm gonna go with. Nothing wrong with a good cobalt. You can hear all this paint that I have. I just absolutely love the paint. I think I'm gonna go with this magenta. Give it a little break in the monotony. Excuse me again. I'm not sure something's tickling my throat. All right, so I'm gonna come in with the cobalt. Now I've changed the size of my brush. This is the number 2 round. Now you can check in your box, because you know, we're speaking futuristically. You know, if you guys tune in, you'll be able to paint with me, so you can reach in your box and get the brush that I futuristically will send to you, you know, when you subscribe and, you know, when you decide to become a member and want to be a part of this virtual canvas and cocktails up in here. So yeah, this is what I'm going to do. Now, I'm also going to come around and kind of make some marks that will be reminiscent of detail and create kind of a tone for my picture. Okay. See if you can see that. Can you see that? Can you see that? All right. Now, I'm gonna go in, add my pink. I'm gonna switch back to my big brush that I was already using. I'm gonna add my pink. Add my magenta. Magenta's always good. There's nothing wrong with a little paint. Nothing wrong with a little paint. And I personally like thick paint. It creates a very nice texture on the picture. So I'm just going in and randomly making my marks. I'm gonna come around here and finish off my edges. My edges shall not go unpainted. Paint your edges. Pick your canvas up and get my sides. Ooh. There we go. Now, nothing wrong with getting personal with your canvas. Pick it up. It loves you. You should love it. It's gonna be hanging in your house somewhere. Be personal with it. A very unorthodox artist right here. Usually you can find me sitting on the floor with a canvas laying on my legs, paint. So you see my edges are done. Edges are done. I'm gonna get the bottom, just flip it over. Do my edges. And another thing you'll find out in later classes, when you change the perspective of the picture that you're painting, you're able to paint it almost better. So sometimes you'll see me turn my canvas upside down. You want to get everywhere. Okay, see? I'm gonna flip it again. Come back around, and our background is done. At least done as much as it can be done for now. Alright. So we are going to take a break. Got a little bit more pink in here. I'm gonna come back over this horizon line. Alright, we're gonna go to commercial break and then we come back. Commercial break. Brought to you by Shim 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 Dum Dum Dum. Make sure you read the small print before you begin taking this. Please don't take if you are pregnant or planning on operating any heavy machinery. I'm gonna let this dry and I'll be back. Okay. I am back. So, we left off at our water, and what you can see here is that I've begun to add my white. Now I'm gonna come and remember that my center focal point, and this is gonna be the reflection of the light on the water. So I'm just gonna add this right down the middle. So we have a nice reflection right down the middle of our canvas. Okay. Now, here is when the work comes in. Takes a kind of a steady hand, but have no fear. As you can see, I'm going into my black. I love black. Beautiful. It will define your picture so nicely. So the first thing that I'm gonna do is go to my smaller brush. I'm gonna dip into my white and a little bit of my blue. Make me kind of a light blue. And I think I want my boat to have a little bit of purple in it. So this is the color I'm mixing for my boat. It's gonna come out sort of a periwinkle. Your boat can be whatever color you want it to be. Okay? It's your boat. Paint your boat the way you want your boat to be. It's your fucking boat. Okay? So, we're gonna find the center of our canvas, or approximately the center, or wherever you want your boat to be positioned. You may want your boat to be over here. You may want your boat to be up here. Now, if it's up there, it's gonna fly. It's not gonna be in the water. It's gonna look a little crazy. Just letting you know that, okay? Let me fix the camera. All right. So, I'm gonna put a line here for my bow. I believe that's what it's called. My bow. See that? You see that? Yeah, see that? See if you can see that. See that line? That's where my bow's gonna go, right there. I'll actually bring this closer. I zoom in while I sketch this boat out for you. Okay. Create the bow of our boat. And then I'm gonna make a U. Switch to my larger brush again. Back to my large brush. So I'm going to fill this in. And I'm going to start with my darker purple along the outside. Okay. Okay. My boat comes out like that. My boat is taking shape. So I've got my purple in there. And then I'm gonna blend it out with some white. I need more white. To my brush. I'm gonna add a little bit more white. A little bit of white to my brush. Go ahead and blend it in. Now, if I have ladies painting with me, which I'm sure I do, and you're familiar with doing makeup, this is pretty much the same thing, the blending. Now, you just don't want to leave contour lines. Gotta blend those in, or you'll be walking around with stripes on your face. That'll look crazy. Or maybe you can start a new makeup trend. Who knows? Make sure my bow is nice. Here we go. Got a boat on the water. Now, I'm going to come back with my reflection. My white here. Bring it around. And I also want to bring some color into the bed. So you'll see some yellow, and you'll see some purple and orange all around the boat. Okay. Now, I'm going to go back into my white. Actually, this is what I'm going to have you do first. I'm going to grab your small detail brush. And we are going to draw a straight line right down the center. Something of a straight line. Down the center of it. Okay. And then what I'm gonna do is this little hook here. More detail there. A line on my boat there. More detail here. Now, next thing, I'm gonna move to my larger round brush. Okay, this is an 8. I am going to make my sails. Now, this sail is not exactly on the black line. You want to put it right next to it. I'm just going to draw a line straight down. Now if you need to, and this is another thing that will be in your box, I'm going to include some baby wipes. You don't have to worry about mistakes. Baby wipes are magical. They take it right back down to the white, so if you truly, truly mess up, you will always be able to start over again. Okay, so I've made my triangle, and I'm going to begin to fill it in with my white. Now to create some depth in this sail, I'm going to use a little bit of my color that I have on my plate. So I'm going to bleed in a very light amount of pink into this white of the sail. Got a little bit of fuchsia going on in here. I'll put a little bit of blue in there. Now remember, acrylic is a water-based paint, and you don't ever really want to be painting with a dry brush. Unless you're doing a dry brush technique. So, a little bit more detail here. Okay, here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna bring this out a little more. See the joys of painting? You can always fix it. I'm gonna bring that out just a tad more.
From Bedford Nissan. Happy holidays to you and your family. December is a special time at Bedford Nissan. It's year-end for us too, and our deals are unbelievable. With 0% financing and many of these specials under $200 a month, there is there's never been a better time to get your next car. And don't forget, Bedford Nissan Pandora listeners get an extra gift this holiday, free maintenance with your purchase. So stop by Bedford Nissan this holiday season for the best deals and service in Northeast Ohio on the Bedford Auto Mile or at BedfordNissan.com. Bounty Paper Towels presents Dropping the Beat. Right now, you may or may not be dropping your coffee cup, but the music you're listening to is definitely dropping the beat. And when the beat drops, you drop it low. And if you're dropping it low, there's a high chance you spilled something. And that's why Bounty is the quicker picker-upper. So you can get back to dropping it low quicker. Bounty.
Now we shall move on to our next sale. It's gonna come around here. Okay. Can you see that line? And this is about the time where right brain totally kicks in. You relax and begin to just start to create. This is the part of art that I just absolutely love. So we got our sale in there. I think I'm gonna give a little pink. Give a little pink to this sale. Give a little pink. I'm gonna blend that in. Put too much paint. Fix it with the white. Yeah. There we go. There we go. Okay, now I'm gonna come back with my baby brush and make this a little longer. My first there. I'm also gonna come on through all the way down. Gotta connect them, right? Should I? This is gonna give you a go. You're gonna do a line. Just take your time. Don't press so heavily with your brush. Really give it a light press. Now, this is the fun part. I get to add whatever type of detail I want. So I'm going to blend this the way I want it to be. I'm going to add some darker purple around the outside. Right along here. Something knows that hate. Does it seem colder in your summertime? And tend to do that while I'm painting. Be in my song. If it was just a thing. Alright. More definition. And then I am going to add some boats. And maybe bird. I know this little seagull is out there. Some small little birds, little half in. How we looking here? Hope you guys enjoyed this picture. What you see me doing is refining and adding a little detail, a little color where I may want it, where I don't feel it's at. Finishing filling in my eye. Things that make me happy. I throw a little bit of orange up here in the boat. Give your eyes somewhere to go. Come back and redefine our little boats. And we are done. Last thing you need to do, always have to do, is sign your name to your picture, to your boat. My little initial right in the corner. Got a nice picture from the house. Can hang it anywhere. A little bit of birds in here. Thank you for tuning in. I'll see you next week.